Hey guys, this is Josh here with Trillium Wild Edibles. These plants that you see in front of you are bloodroot. There are a couple of ways that you can tell this. First and foremost, you're going to notice the straight up growing leaf with six lobes. And on each lobe, you're going to notice these rounded teeth-like lobes. And you're going to see a lot of variation. You can see a different leaf here. These leaves always grow straight up, and there's only one leaf on each plant. You'll also note this extremely beautiful white flower. This is the time of year when the flowers start losing their petals because it's an extremely early spring flower. It's one of the earliest spring flowers that we have in the eastern woodlands. Usually on these flowers, you're going to notice anywhere from 7 to 10 petals. However, like I said, usually within a couple days after flowering, they already start dropping their petals. You can see this one's dropping its petals now. And this is what they're going to look like before the flowers even open, which they look pretty cool and they look beautiful here. They look kind of like a white buttercup. And you can see this extremely small bloodroot leaf here. You can see how I just touched it and the petals just fell off. That's not a big deal. That's not me harming or killing or destroying the plant in any way. This is just natural this time of year. Any light touch, these petals are going to start falling off. Like I said, these flowers only bloom for 1 to 2 days, and that's it. However, these leaves will remain for a good portion of the growing season, so that's good. So as long as you spot these leaves, you know you found some bloodroot. This plant isn't edible. It is medicinal, though I would not recommend using it internally unless you are prescribed it by a doctor or physician or homeopathist or something of that sort. The reason for that being, this root contains sanguinarine, which is said to cause glaucoma. This plant's root is very shallow. It doesn't take very much effort to get to. Usually you can get away with just using your finger. And here you can see why it's called blood root, and the reason for that is whenever you damage or cut the root, it's going to spit out this red juice that's similar to blood. This red juice was traditionally used by Native Americans in the eastern woodlands as a red skin dye or a red skin paint. You can also use it to dye textiles as well if you so choose to go through all that effort. However, I wouldn't recommend doing it only because this plant's so beautiful. I wouldn't recommend tearing it up. It does have medicinal uses, but like I said, I'm not going to go into any of that because this plant can be extremely dangerous, and this plant can cause glaucoma according to some reports and some studies, and it's just because of the amount of sanguinarine that is in this root. But if I take this red portion of the root and rub it on my skin, you're going to notice this red stain. And as you can see, it would take quite a bit of this to make red skin dye or red skin paint. So again, it's not something I would recommend doing. However, this root does have an external medical use that I will talk about, and that is supposedly it's good for removing warts. I haven't used it for that, mainly because I usually use dandelion or wild lettuce or milkweed sap. However, you can apply this red juice to a wart, and it's said to remove them. Again, I don't know if that works or not, because I haven't tried it. I thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you learned something. If you want to learn more about edible or medicinal plants, make sure to subscribe.